Welcome dear students, and today we will see how to determine bulk density and tap density of powder or granule. This is the one of the evaluation parameter of granules and powders. So now we are going to see how to determine it. This is the apparatus which is used to determine tap density. Aim to determine bulk density and tapped density of powders or granules. Requirements. For this experiment, we required powder or granule sample, one apparatus, funnel, graduated measuring cylinder, stopwatch, then bulk density apparatus, and weighing balance. What are the pharmaceutical powders exactly? So these powders are defined as a dry solid substance composed of finely divided drugs with or without excipient and intended for internal or external use. It is a solid substance in finely divided state, typically obtained by crushing, grinding, and comminuting. Then classification of powders. Based on degree of coarseness or fineness of pharmaceutical substance in a powder form are expressed by a reference or nominal mesh aperture size of sieve used. For cases in which use of sieves inappropriate, it is expressed as a particle size determined by microscopic examination as a micrometer. So first type of powder or first class of powder, that is coarse powder. In this class, all particles must be passed through mesh aperture 1700 micrometer, and not more than 40% of it should pass through mesh aperture 355. Then moderately coarse powder, all particles must pass through mesh aperture 710 micrometer, and not more than 40% by weight of the powder should pass through a mesh aperture 250 micrometer. Then third class, that is fine powder. All these fine particles must pass through mesh aperture 180 micrometer, and not more than 40% by weight should pass through mesh aperture 125 micrometer. Then fourth class, that is very fine powder. So in this class, all particles must pass through mesh aperture 125 micrometer, and not more than 40% by weight should pass through mesh aperture 45 micrometer. Then fifth class, microfine powder. So particle from this class not less than 90% by weight should pass through the mesh aperture 45 micrometer. Then superfine powder. Particles not less than 90% by weight should pass through aperture 10 micrometer. So these are the different classes of powder. Now we'll see what is granulation. So granulation is a process, may be defined as a process where in a small particles are adhered together by forming a bond between them and are resulting in the formation of large aggregate, and that aggregate is nothing but granule. So spraying the binder solution on a powder There is a formation of liquid bridge like this and a solid bridge. And because of this solid bridge, there is a formation of granule. Evaluation characteristic of granules or powders. Particle size and shape determination. Then surface area. Then density. This density include bulk density, true density, granular density. Then fourth one is granule strength and friability. Then flow property. These flow properties include angle of repose, then compressibility index, Hausner's ratio, then moisture content and percentage fineness. So these are the evaluation characteristics or parameters for the granules and powders. Then volume. So there are different types of the volumes. First is true volume. It is a volume of particles only. It does not include interspace and intraspace volume. Normally, true volume is obtained by the liquid displacement method, as volume of liquid is displaced by that particles. Then granule volume, it is volume of powder including intra-particle spaces. Therefore, it includes volume of granules plus volume of powders. Bulk volume, it is the true volume of powder including inter-particle and intra-particle pores. Tapped volume, it is volume of powder determined by tapping a measuring cylinder containing wetted amount of powder. The cylinder is tapped for about 1 minute to get a constant volume, and that volume is nothing but tapped volume of that particular powder. Then void volume, the void volume of spaces between particle is known as the void volume. Then density, true density, it is a weight of powder divided by its volume excluding the void and intra-particle pores of smaller dimensions. It is determined from helium densitometer. Helium penetrates the small pores and crevices but is not absorbed by powder. So you will come to know that true density of powder. Then percent porosity is determined by this true density. Next, granule density. It is a weight of granules divided by its volume. Then bulk density. It is weight of powder or granule divided by its volume. Bulk density is used to check uniformity in a powder material to decide the size of container, equipment for production, size of a packing material and a selecting size of empty gelatin capsule. The reciprocal of bulk density is called as bulkiness or bulk. Based on bulk, powders are classified as light powders and heavy powders. Then tapped density. The tapped density is an increased bulk density attained after mechanically tapping a container containing the powder sample. The tapped density is obtained by mechanically tapping a graduated measuring cylinder or vessel containing the powder sample. In both the cases, bulk as well as tapped density calculation, you have to take weight upon volume. But you have to take a volume before tapping for the calculation of bulk density, and in case of tap density you have to tap this measuring cylinder, and then that tapped volume you have to consider for the calculation. This is the difference between the bulk density and tap density. Because of this tapping, what happens, interparticle distance get reduced. Next thing, that is porosity. So it is a total space which is present in a collection of powder, whether the powder is porous or non-porous. The total porosity expression for the calculation remains same. The porosity may be defined as a ratio of void volume to the bulk volume. The porosity is always expressed in a percentage. The porosity of powder depends upon the type of packing. The packing is of two types, namely closed packing and open packing. Information about hardness, disintegration and tablet porosity, which is in turn related with dissolution and release of drug, is obtained from porosity. So equation for the porosity. Porosity is equal to bulk volume minus tapped volume divided by tapped volume. Then applications. It helpful to decide a size of capsule based on bulk and tapped volume of the given sample. If higher bulk volume, lower will be your bulk density, and bigger size of capsule is required for the filling of that material. Then it helps to decide a proper size of container and packing material for filling that particular powder and granules. Then we'll see exact procedure how to determine this bulk density and tap density along with porosity. So what you have to do, first of all, weigh accurately fixed amount of powder, still from 5 to 50 you can take any amount. Then place it in a dried graduated measuring cylinder and note its volume, and that volume will be your V1 volume. Then in third step, place the cylinder containing sample in a bulk density apparatus. Adjust apparatus for 100 tapping and operate it. So you have to set your apparatus in such a way that your cylinder will be tapped 100 times. Then record the volume occupied by the powder at a V2 ml. Okay, means when initially you have filled your powder, then its volume obviously will be more, and after tapping it will be reduced, means volume of V2 will be always less as compared to the V1, because you are giving the tapping for that measuring cylinder. Then this is the bulk density apparatus. So this apparatus consists of two measuring cylinder along with the cap. You have to fill your powder in this measuring cylinder and you have to set it for the 100 taps. So in such a way, you can calculate this bulk density. Now we'll see actual demonstration.
Now first step is weighing of granules. So I'm going to take a 25 gram of granules in these butter paper. Okay, now I'm weighing this second set of granules. Okay, again it is 25 gram. Okay, these two sets are ready to use. Okay, this is bulk density apparatus. It is having a on-off switch. Then one more switch for the setting of time. And this is the reset button for the purpose of resetting of the time. Okay, these two digits denotes this time in second, and these two digit denotes the time into the minutes. Okay, now this bulk density apparatus also consists of these two arms, left and right arm, and this left and right arm consists of this measuring cylinder along with the cap, okay, in which we are going to fill our sample. Okay, then this measuring cylinder is having a measurement cell from the 5 ml to 50 ml. Okay, and this apparatus consists of this two cylinder for the purpose of balancing, means same amount of powder or granule you have to fill into this both measuring cylinder. Put this measuring cylinder from this bulk density apparatus, and then I am going to fill these granules into these two measuring cylinder. So here I have filled a weighted amount of granules, that is 25 gram of granules, into this measuring cylinder, and almost its volume is 43 ml. So for the reading purpose you can consider any arm. Okay, now we are going to consider only the right arm for the reading purpose, and its bulk volume is 43 ml. Now I am going to start this apparatus. This apparatus tap almost 33 to 34 tap per minute. So I am setting a time 3 minutes. So we will get 100 tap in this 3 minute. Okay, now I am setting the time. Okay, it is 3 minutes. Now it start to work. Thank you. Okay, now our 3 minute time is over and this bulb density apparatus stop and start to buzzer. Okay, now we'll see how much volume is there after tapping. Okay, after completion of 100 taps, the volume of this granule is almost 36 ml. So our bulk volume before tapping, it was 43 ml and now it is 36 ml. So because of tapping, reduction in the volume is there. Okay, now we have a bulk volume and tap volume with us. Now we'll proceed for the calculation.
Now we have an observation with us. Mass of powder we have taken was 25 gram. Bulk volume of that 25 gram of granules was 43 ml and after tapping it was 36 ml. Now we'll see how to determine bulk density and tap density. So formula for the bulk density, mass upon bulk volume. So we have a mass of powder that is 25 gram and its volume was 43. That's why bulk density of given granules found to be 0.5819 gram per ml. Similarly, we can calculate tapped density by using formula mass upon tapped volume. So W1 divided by V2, V2 is nothing but tapped volume. So 25 divided by 36, then we have an answer with us, that is 0.6944 gram per ml. So these are the bulk and tap densities of our granules. Now we'll see result. Bulk density of given granules was found to be 0.5813 gram per ml and tapped density of given granules found to be 0.6944 gram per ml. So tapped density is more because distribution of granules is too much dense when you tap it. Now we'll see questions that will be asked for the synopsis and viva. Define bulk density. It is a weight of powder or granules. It's divided by its volume. So bulk density is used to check the uniformity of powder material to decide the size of container, equipment for the production, sizes of packing material and selecting size of empty gelatin capsule when you are going to fill the granules into that capsule. Then define tapped density. Tapped density is an increased bulk density attained after mechanically tapping a container containing powder sample or granule sample. The tap density obtained by mechanically tapping the graduated measuring cylinder or vessel containing powder sample. Then what is porosity? A porosity is defined as a ratio of void volume to bulk volume. Equation is Vb minus Vp upon Vb, that is bulk volume minus actual volume divided by bulk volume, then we'll get value of porosity. What are the methods of granulation? Dry granulation, wet granulation, direct compression, then next question. What are the evaluation parameter for granules? So, first evaluation parameter, particle size and shape determination, surface area, then density in that density, bulk density is there, crew density is there, granular density is there. Then fourth parameter, that is granular strength and friability. Then flow properties, inflow properties, angle of repose, percentage compressibility index, Hausner's ratio. Then sixth parameter, that is moisture content. Then percentage of fines. So these are the evaluation parameters of granules. Then what is the purpose of determining the bulk density of powder? So it is an essential parameter for process development and solid dosage manufacturing. It is used in determining amount of powder that can fit in a space such as a blender or a hopper or on a tablet press or capsule filler. It is also used to determine the amount of powder that can be fitted into the capsule. So this is all about the how to determine tab density and bulk density. Thank you for watching.